Hello my dear students, welcome to CMIS online classes. In today's class, we will continue with chapter 3 of our English literature, that is a poem, and the title of this poem is Somebody's Mother. So in this video, we will discuss and solve the questions from this chapter. The questions here in this exercise is are in the forms of excerpts that have been taken stanza wise from the poem itself. So we will start our discussion and solve the questions. So now the first question of exercise B, answer the following with reference to the context. So question number one is, the first we have the stanza from the poem that reads like, the woman was old and ragged and grey and bent with the chill of a winter's day. The streets were white with the recent snow and the woman's feet were aged and slow. So here it is written here, this stanza describes us about the old woman, how she was. So it is the question here, the first question number A is here, describe the woman. So the answer is the old woman was wearing old and torn out clothes. That means वो बूढ़ी औरत कैसी थी, she was old, we already know because we have used the adjective here old, but if we have to describe her, she was wearing old and torn out clothes. उसके पास वो पुराने और फटे हुए कपड़े पहने हुए थी. Her hair was grey. That means she was very old. The streets were slippery due to the recent snowfall, and the old woman's feet were moving slow. Okay, so this is the answer of question number one. Now, question number B. B of question number one. What kind of day was it? So it was a winter day. So we already know the old woman was trembling of cold also. So it was a winter day. Now, question number C of question number one. Why does the poet say that the woman's feet were aged and slow? The answer is, the poet says that the woman's feet were aged and slow as she was weak and walking so slow to cross the road. Okay, this is the answer. And now, question number two. The question number two also has the stanza from the poem, and the stanza reads like this. She stood at the crossing and waited long, alone, uncared for, amid the throng. The word throng here is used to describe crowd of people, the crowd of people. Of human beings who passed her by, nor heeded the glance of her anxious eye. So the questions based on this stanza, question number A is here. Who was waiting? What was the person waiting for? See here. Who was waiting here? The old woman. Okay, the old woman was waiting to cross the road. Okay. What was the person waiting for? The person was waiting to cross the road. She wanted to go to the other side of the road. That means she wanted to go her home. And to reach her home, she had to cross the road. Now, question B from number 2. Who was passing by? So the old woman was standing among the crowd of people. So the crowd of people was passing by. Understood. Now, question number 3 from number 2. What was the attitude of people around the person? See, attitude means the behavior of people around the person, and the person here is the old woman. See, the old woman was standing among the crowd, But no one cared for her. No one came to ask her what she needed and did not help her cross the road. That means the attitude of the people was not good towards this old woman, because no one there among the crowd asked her, came to her to help her. Now, question number 3 from the context. This is also a stanza from the poem, and the stanza reads like this. At last, out of the merry troop, the gayest laddie of all the group, he paused beside her and whispered low, I'll help you cross if you wish to go. So here, the question number A based on this stanza is, who are being described as the merry troop? So we already know that the time when the old woman was waiting to cross the road for long, there comes a group of students after the school was over. And the merry troop here is the group of students coming out after the school was over. Okay. Now question number B. Who is being described as the gayest laddie? So here laddie refers to lad or a kid. Okay. Now here the gayest laddie here is the happiest or the merriest boy in the group of students who came forward to help the old woman cross the road. Okay. Now question number C from number 3. What did the boy say to the old woman? So we also know from the poem that the boy looked at the old woman and asked that if she wished to cross the road, the boy would help. The boy asked the old woman that he would help her if she wanted to cross the road. Okay. Now question number 4 from exercise B. This is also a stanza, and the stanza reads like this. Her aged hand on his strong young arm, she placed, and so without hurt or harm, he guided her trembling feet along, proud that his own were firm and strong. Then back again to his friends he went, his young heart happy and well content. Here the word content means satisfied. Okay. Happy of doing some work. So now question number A from question number 4. See, whose arm was young and strong? So here the young and strong arm refers to the arm of the boy who helped the old woman to cross the road. The boy's arm was young and strong. Very simple answer. Okay. Now question number B from question number 4. Why did the person feel proud that his legs were firm and strong? That means why did the boy feel proud that his legs were firm and strong? See, why did the boy feel proud? उस लड़के को गर्व महसूस क्यों हुआ कि उसका पैर और कंधा मजबूत था? The answer is, the boy was proud that his legs were firm and strong as he was able to help the old woman, the old and helpless woman cross the road, because he was able to use his strength for some good cause. Here the good cause is to help that old woman. Okay. So he was proud. Proud for good reason. Understood. Now the next question is question number 3 from number 4 of exercise B. Describe how the person helped the old woman cross the street. So the person who helped the old woman here is the boy. Okay. So उस लड़के ने कैसे उस बूढ़ी औरत को मदद किया, किस तरीके से मदद किया, उसे वर्णन करना है, उसे एक्सप्लेन करना है. सी द ओल्ड वुमन प्लेस्ड हर हैंड्स ऑन द यंग बॉयज आर्म. ओके, सो उस बूढ़ी औरत ने अपने हाथ उस लड़के के कंधे पर रखा. द बॉय गाइडेड द ट्रेम्बलिंग फीट ऑफ द ओल्ड वुमन. उस लड़के ने उस बूढ़ी औरत के कांपते हुए पैरों को भी सहारा दिया. विदाउट एनी हार्म एंड वेरी लविंगली, विदाउट एनी हार्म, किसी तरीके का चोट पहुंचाए हुए बहुत प्यार से द बॉय हेल्प द ओल्ड वुमन क्रॉस द रोड. इस तरीके से उस लड़के ने उस बूढ़ी औरत को सहारा दिया उसे रोड क्रॉस करने में. सो दीज वर ऑल क्वेश्चंस एंड आंसर्स फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज बी ऑफ आवर चैप्टर 3 पोएम समबडीज मदर. नाउ वी ऑल्सो हैव सम क्वेश्चंस एंड आंसर्स, सम क्वेश्चंस इन एक्सरसाइज ए. आई होप यू विल बी एबल टू डू दोज क्वेश्चंस एंड यू विल डू दोज क्वेश्चंस by yourselves in your notebooks. This much for today's class. Thank you so much.